Hi friends, this is Subhabrata Basu. Welcome back to my channel. Today I will discuss the WB SET exam question paper with answers. Before going to my discussion, please subscribe my channel and click the all videos so that all notifications come at first to you. Now let's start. The first question in the paper English of WB SET, which was conducted probably in 19th January 2020, was: the Australian-born classical scholar Gilbert Murray is the original of saws. There are four options. The answer is Cousins in Major Barbara. That is option B. Cousins in Major Barbara. Next question. In which of her books does Julia Kristeva introduce the idea of the abject? The answer is option A, Powers of Horror. Next question, question number 3. Match the writers in list 1 with their ideas in list 2. In the list 1, there are Raymond Williams, J.L. Austin, Michel Foucault, Mikhail Bakhtin. And in the list 2, there are speech act theory, dialogism, Marxism, post-structuralism. So in the question, which author or which theorist is related to which theory? The answer will be option number B. That is, in the list 1, there is Raymond Williams, who is related to Marxism. Next, J.L. Austin is related to speech act theory. Next, Mikhail Bakhtin is related to post-structuralism. And finally, Michel Foucault is related to post-structuralism. And finally, Mikhail Bakhtin is related to dialogism. Next question, question number 4. Given below are two statements, one labeled as assertion A and the other reason. Assertion A, in As You Like It, Jenny-Mate faints when he sees the handkerchief covered with Orlando's blood after he was injured by the lioness. But as soon as Jenny-Mate recovers, he tries to act as if the fainting was only a pretense, well counterfeited. And in the reason, there is Jenny-Mate is actually Rosalind, disguised as a man with the sensibility of a woman and a tender heart. Since she does not want Orlando and Oliver to suspect her, she desperately tries to pass it off as pretense. In the light of the above, indicate the correct option. The answer is both A and R are true, that is, both assertion and reason are true, and R is correct explanation of A. That is, reason is the correct explanation of assertion. Next, I am coming to the question number 5. Who coined the term macaronic theater? The answer is Marvin Carlson. Next, question number 6. But while I have a sword, a hand, a heart, I will not yield to any such upstart. Who is this upstart referred to? The answer is Gabstone. Option B, Gabstone. Next, question number 7. Robinson Crusoe lived in an uninhabited island for, there are four options, 28 years, 26 years, 13 years, 37 years. The answer is 28 years, that is option A. Next question. In language learning, monitor model hypothesis is attributed to Stephen Krasen, B.F. Skinner, Jha Piaget, Noam Chomsky. The answer is Stephen Krasen, that is option A is the right answer. Next question number 9. Longinus on the Sublime begins with an attack on the incompleteness of the work of a Greek rhetorician called. The answer is Caecilius. Option D, Caecilius. Next question, question number 10. Which of the modern plays by a British playwright puts Shakespeare as a character on stage? There are four options: Edward Bond's Bingo, Harold Pinter's Mountain Language, Therese Rattigan's Inspector Calls, Joe Orton's Loot. The right option is option A, Edward Bond's Bingo. Next, question number 11. Which of the following sentences is not a tautology? There are four options. There is a lot of frozen ice on the road. The market was in close proximity to the bomb blast. The hotel room was not great, but it was adequate. Having a fitness test is a necessary requirement for the job. The answer, right answer is option C. That is, the hotel room was not great, but it was adequate. Next question, question number 12. Which of the following is not a detective character? There are four options: Father Brown, Reginald Wexford, Annie Catherick, Mike Hooligan. The right answer is Annie Catherick. Question number 13. Bracketing is a term used in phenomenological criticism to describe option A, meeting of the writer's world and the reader's world, meeting of the writer's world and the publisher's world, meeting of the writer's language and the reader's language, meeting of the writer's world and the world of the writer's inner self. The right answer is meeting of the writer's world and the reader's world. Next question, question number 14. Please watch till the end so that you can watch and know all the questions are and answers that came in the last WB West Bengal set examinations. If you found any answer incorrect, please put a comment in my videos. In which language, question number 14, in which language did Namdeo Dhasal originally write? Sindhi, Marathi, Gujarati, Oriya. The right answer is Marathi. Question number 15. Jhumpa Lahiri's short story When Mr. Pirzada Came to Dine mainly concentrates on the difference between two generations of Indian Americans, an Indian and a Bangladeshi, Indians and Americans, Bengalis and Punjabis. The right answer is an Indian and a Bangladeshi. Next question number 16. In Tradition and the Individual Talent, Eliot speaks about the working of the poet's mind in terms of which of the following modalities? The answer is a chemical reaction, that is option B, chemical reaction. Next question, question number 17. The Tragicomedy, which is the product of the English theatre, is one of the most monstrous inventions that ever entered into a poet's thought. Who said this? The answer is option C, Joseph Addison. Next, question number 18. Palgrave's Golden Treasury was published in the year. The right answer is 1861, that is option A. Next, in the question number 19, there is a matching of list 1 with list 2. In the list 1, there is Eliot's London, Yeats by Byzantium, plus San Francisco, Ezra Pound's Paris, and in the list too, there are the young in one another's arm, barred in the trees, those dying generations. That is the lines from the poem of the poets. There is a matching of color list one and list two. In the second of the list two, I think we are in Rat's Alley, where the dead men lost their bones. And in the three list two, the question number three, the apparition of these faces in the crowd, petals on a wet black bough. And in the four, ghastly statue with one great toe, big as Frisco seal. The option, the right answer is C. That is, Eliot's London is related to, or the line which is found in Eliot's London is option 2 in the list 2. I think we are in Rat's Alley, where the dead men lost their bones. And then in Byzantium, we find the young in one another's arm, barred in the trees, those dying generations. In Plath San Francisco, we find ghastly statue with one great toe, big as a Frisco seal. That is 4 in list 2. And then lastly, in Ezra Pound's Paris, we find the apparition of these faces in the crowd, petals on a wet black bough. Question number 20. Marx Scurer, in his technique as discovery, considered art as different from life because art carries the stamp of. The right answer is option A, objectivity, universality, dramatization, and evaluation. Next, question number 21. Here is also a matching with list 1, of list 1 with list 2. In list 1, there is Manjula Padmanabhan, Dina Mehta, Polly Sengupta, Santarama Pau. In the list 2, Mangalam, A Passage to India, Lights Out, Brides Are Not, for Burning. The right answer is option A, that is, Manjula Padmanabhan is related to Lights Out, Dina Mehta is related to Brides Are Not for Burning, Poyli Sengupta is related to Mangalam, and Santa Rama Rao is related to A Passage to India. Next, question number 22. Which of the following novelists does not show fictionality of the text? The answer is, right answer is, George Meredith. There are four options, among which the right answer is option D, George Meredith. Question number 23. Here are some of the opening lines from Bertolt Brecht's The Missing of Dialogues. A stage on which the stagehand is slowly dismantling the set. An actor, a dramaturgy, and a philosopher are sitting on chairs. The actor pours the wine into glasses and hands it round. The actor, all this dust makes it thirsty, works sitting on a stage. You'd better take a good swig. Choose the correct option from the ones given below. The right answer is option B, that is, the above passage is an example of mimesis. Next, question number 24. The fugitives and the agrarians are linked to. The answer is, you will write the answer in the comment. I am not telling the answer. Please put a comment and tell the answer of the question number 24. It is left for you. Next, question number 25. Thou wast not born for death, immortal bird, no hungry generations trade thee down. The voice I heard, this passing rite was heard in ancient days by emperor and clown. In what sense is the bird immortal? Given below are four statements. Choose the correct answer. The correct answer is option D, that is, C and D are correct. If the voice in the third line stands for the nightingale song, unchanged from age to age, contrasted with the transient passing night, then it is immortal. And the option D, the bird is immortal in the sense that its song has been bringing joy to human beings through the ages. Next, question number 26. Rose called Macbeth Bellona's bridegroom because the right answer is option B, Macbeth was as valiant as Mars. Next, question number 27. The question is, but oh thou terrible, why wouldest thou rude on me? Thy ring walled right foot rock, lay a lion limb against me, scan with darksome devouring eyes my bruised bones. Perhaps this may be the sonnet written in blood about a struggle raw in its blood and bone, about which Hopkins wrote to Robert Browning in 1885. Which sonnet is this? The answer is Carry On Comfort. The right answer is Carry On Comfort. Next, question number 28. Longinus says things that sublime consist in a certain loftiness and excellence of language. Longinian excellence of language refers to. The right answer is appropriateness of language. That is option C. Next, question number 29. Which of the following cannot be called a Bildungsroman? The answer is option D, Daniel Defoe's Robinson Crusoe. Next, question number 30. New historicism was fundamentally influenced. Option D, the right answer is option D, Foucault. And in the question 31, who among the following wrote a poem giving the same title as John Donne did, A Valediction, Forbidding Morning? The right answer is option A, Adrian Rich. Next question. Question number 32. There is also a matching of list 1 with list 2. In list 1, there are Christopher Isherwood's Mr. Norris Changes Trains, Evelyn Waugh's Vile Bodies, George Orwell's The Road to Wigan Pier, Graham Greene's. And in the list 2, there are Lancashire and Yorkshire, Berlin, London, Sierra Leone. The right answer is option C. That is, A is related to Berlin, B is related to London, C is related to Lancashire and Yorkshire, and finally, Graham Greene is related to Sierra Leone. Next, question number 33. Johnson's comedies mostly deal with his favorite theme of human greed. Which of the comedies listed below is an exception? The right answer is Epicoene. Next, question number 34. According to Barnard's law, the voiceless consonants P, T and K changed to the voiced consonants B, D, G when they came after. The right answer is an unstressed syllable. That is, right answer is option B. Next, question number 35. Who and in which document sought to change the people of India in the following manner? A class of persons, Indian in blood and color, but English in taste, in opinion, in morals and in intellect, who may be interpreters between us and the millions whom we govern. The right answer is option C, Lord Macaulay and the Minute on Indian Education. That is 1835. Next, question number 36. There is also a matching list. In list 1, there is Chitra Banerjee, दिवाकारुणी, भारती मुखर्जी, हरि कुंजरू, सुनेत्रा गुप्ता, एंड इन लिस्ट बी देयर इज मेमोरीज ऑफ रेन, द ट्री ब्राइड, द फॉरेस्ट ऑफ एंचेंटमेंट, मेमोरी पैलेस. द राइट आंसर इज ऑप्शन डी, दैट इज चित्रा बनर्जी दिवाकारुणी इज रिलेटेड टू द फॉरेस्ट ऑफ एंचेंटमेंट, भारती मुखर्जी इज रिलेटेड टू द ट्री ब्राइड, हरि कुंजरू इज रिलेटेड टू मेमोरी पैलेस, एंड फाइनली सुनेत्रा गुप्ता इज रिलेटेड टू मेमोरीज ऑफ रेन. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन नंबर 37. द 2016 हिंदी रोमांटिक फिल्म फितूर इज एन एडाप्टेशन ऑफ, द आंसर इज ग्रेट एक्सपेक्टेशंस. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, कैमेरा लुसिडा इज ए बुक बाय, द राइट आंसर इज रोला बार्थ, ऑप्शन ए रोला बार्थ. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, क्वेश्चन नंबर 39. एलिजा एन ए फ्रेसर 1798 टू 1858 was a Scottish woman who was aboard a ship that wrecked at an island off the coast of Queensland, Australia on 22nd May 1836, and who was taken by the Batjala Buchela people. Which novel by Patrick White adapts that story? The right answer is option B, A Fringe of Leaves. A Fringe of Leaves. Next, question number 40. Which of the following characteristics is not true of the emerging mode of prose poetry? The right answer is it is expository and not emotive. Next, question number 41. Which of the following is the proper sequence for writing a dissertation? Write a preliminary draft, develop a thesis statement, state your purpose in writing a paper, make an outline to help you keep to your plan as you write. The right answer is option B, that is CBDA, that is the proper sequence. Next, the following is an extract from a famous novel. Read it carefully and answer the question. An overcast September evening, just at nightfall, saw beneath its drooping eyelid Mrs. Sparsit glide out of her carriage, pass down the wooden steps of the little station into a stony road, cross it into a green lane, and become hidden in a summer growth of leaves and branches. One or two late birds sleepily chirping in their nests, and a bat heavily crossing and recrossing her, and the reek of her own tread in the thick dust that felt like velvet, where all Mrs. Sparsit heard or saw until she very softly closed a gate. Next para, she went up to the house, keeping within the shrubbery, and went round it, peeping between the leaves at the lower windows. Most of them were open, as they usually were in such warm weather, but there were no lights yet, and all was silent. She tried the garden with no better effect. She thought of the wood and stole towards it, heedless of long grass and briars, of worms, snails, and slugs, and all the creeping things that be, with her dark eyes and her hook nose warily in advance of her. Mrs. Sparsit softly crossed her way through the thick undergrowth, so intent upon her object that she probably would have done no less if the wood had been a wood of adars. The question is, in the question number 42, why does the September evening seem to have drooping eyelid? Choose the correct answer. The right answer is option C, that is D is correct. It is feeling sleepy because all the flora and fauna around are sleeping, around are feeling sleepy. Next question, question number 43. Question number 43. What does not show that Mrs. Sparsit is self-composed and determined? The right answer is option D, only if the wood of adars, an image of danger and repugnance, had been so repulsive as she would have dropped her project. Next question, question number 44. Whose point of view emerges from the passage? The right answer is, it is the authorial point of view. The right answer is option D. It is the authorial point of view. Next question. Identify the incorrect statement. The right answer is, scientific hypothesis is a scientific theory. Next, 46. Question number 46. There is also a passage. Sir Thomas Bartram tries his best to keep the distinction between himself and his children on one hand and his poor relative Fanny on the other. He says to Mrs. Norris, there will be some difficulty in our way to the distinction proper to be made between the two girls as they grow up. How to preserve in the minds of my daughters the consciousness of what they are, and how without depressing her spirits too far to make her remember that she is not a Miss Bartram. Their rank, fortune, rights, and expectations will always be different. Austin demonstrates the complexity of Sir Thomas Bartram. Which of his characteristics is not depicted in the list below? The right answer is option D, misogyny. Misogyny is the right answer. Next, question number 47. Question number 47. Why were Scott novels called Waverley novels? The right answer is option B, because they were named after Waverley, the first of the series of historical novels that Scott wrote. Next question. Question number 48. The census carried out by the government of India is an example of. The right answer is option C, descriptive research. Next, 49. Which of the following is not a book by Stephen Greenblatt? The right answer is C, Beginnings. Next question. Which was the first book of essays to be published? The right answer is Motet's Essays. Next, question number 51. In question number 51, we can see a statement. Here is a statement followed by two assumptions. With respect to the assumptions, choose the correct option below. Statement. And an autobiography focuses on the sequence of events of the writer's life up to the point of writing, while a memoir covers certain aspects of a writer's life. And the assumption is, the above statement suggests that an autobiography is chronologically ordered, while a memoir is not necessarily so. And the above statement suggests that an autobiography is written in the first person, while a memoir is written in the third person. The right answer is option A. One is correct and two is incorrect. Next, question number 52. There is a matching list. In the list one, there is the ecstasy, the sun rising, to his coy mistress, the good morrow. And in the list two, there are the lines from the poems. For God's sake, we will see the answer. The right answer is option B. That is, A, the ecstasy is related to 2, that is, when love with one another so interanimates two souls that abler soul, which thence doth flow, defects of loneliness control. And the sun rising is related to, for God's sake hold your tongue and let me love. To his coy mistress is related to option 4, that is, my vegetable love should grow faster than empires and more slow, and 100 years should go to praise thine eyes and on thy forehead gaze. And the good motto is related to option 3, that is, my face in thine eyes, thine in mine appears, and true plain hearts do in the faces rest. Next, question number 53. Which of the following American novels was used by Edward Said to illustrate American imperialism? The right answer is Moby Dick. Option D, Moby Dick. Next, question number 54. ProQuest is A. The right answer is text database. Option B, text database. Next, question number 55. A bride reply to the two wisdoms occult plane, a calm illuminator and flame. The lines are from, the right answer is Sri Aurobindo's The Golden Light. Next question number 56. Here are four aspects of the Indian psyche that do not translate very easily into English. The answer is option C. 1, 2 and 3 are correct. That is culturally inflected thought processes. In the option 2, language, especially idioms. And in option 3, style or manner of speaking. Raja Rao mentions three of these qualities in the preface to Kanthapura as being difficult to render into English. Pick the correct combination from the options given below. The right answer is option C. 1, 2 and 3 options are correct. Next question number 57. Which of the following best describes the phrase data abuse protocols in literary research? Plagiarism, translating without permission, non-payment of copyright dues, quoting without acknowledgement. The right answer is option B. 1, 2 and 3 are correct. Next, question number 58. A work can become modern only if it is first postmodern. This line is from The right answer is option A. Answering the question, what is the postmodern? Jean-Francois Lyotard. Next, question number 59. Aristotle in his Poetics mentions three painters, one of whom represents characters above the average. Identify the painter. The right answer is B. Polygnotus. Next, question number 60. The Africans in Heart of Darkness are viewed as. The answer is option C, that is ABDC. They are seen as servile black men. Next, they are viewed as enemies. Next, soon the enemies become criminals in the eyes of the whites. And next, option C, they are presented as rebels by Coots. Next, question number 61. I saw the best minds of my generation destroyed by madness, starving, hysterical, naked. Choose the correct option from the ones given below to explain the phrase starving, hysterical, naked. The right answer is option B, that is the best minds are lacking in proper ideology and conviction. Next, question number 62. Which major English novelist was not included by F.R. Lewis in his The Great Tradition? The answer is option D, Charles Dickens. Next, there is also a matching in question number 63. Match the autobiographies in list 1 with their authors in list 2. In list 1, there is Going Home, Joseph Anton, Up From Slavery and Chronicles. And in the list 2, there are Salman Rushdie, Booker, T. Washington, Bob Dylan and Doris Lessing. The right answer is option B, that is Going Home is related to Doris Lessing, Joseph Anton is related to Salman Rushdie, Up From Slavery is related to Booker T. Washington and Chronicles is related to Bob Dylan. Next, question number 64. The following quotation is from the prologue of play. Pray would you know the reason why I am crying? The comic muse long sick is now a dying. And if she goes, my tears will never stop. Identify the play. The right answer is option B. Goldsmith's She Stoops to Conquer. In question number 65, in T.S. Eliot's The Wasteland, the line that Shakespearean rag is, the right answer is taken from a popular song by Jane Buck and Herman Ruhi in 1912. Next, question number 66, which of the following is originally composed as a graphic novel? The right answer is Margin Satrapi's Persepolis. Next, question number 67. As one a man has been in poor estate and climbeth up and waxeth fortunate and there abideth in prosperity. These lines from Chaucer's non-priest tale bears the influence of the right answer is option C. Boethius de Consolation Philosophy. Next, question number 68. Under which of the following disciplines would a study of styles of dressing be placed? The right answer is option A, semiology. Next question. The first national policy on education was adopted in the Indian Parliament in. The right answer is 1968, option D. Next question. How did R.K. Narayan describe the kind of Indian English he wrote? The right answer is option B, as toasted English. Next question, question number 71. It was said that Uncle Tom's Cabin was the book which started the Great War. Which is the Great War referred to? The right answer is option C, the American Civil War. Next question, question number 72. Peter Carey's Jack Mags is a reworking of Dickens's Great Expectations, but Carey also reinvents Dickens as a young writer called. The right answer is Tobias Oates. That is option number B. That is the right answer, option number B. Next, coming to the question 73. Question number 73. When the Great Vowel shift took place in the English language, the vowels I and U changed to. The right answer is option C, EI and EU. Next, question number 74. The works of Franz Kafka were originally written in. The right answer is German. Next, question number 75. Which of the following books offers an argument diametrically opposed to T.S. Eliot's tradition and the individual talent? The right answer is Harold Bloom, The Anxiety of Influence. Next question, question number 76. Which of the following belongs to the category of good research ethics? The right answer is option B, conducting a review of the literature that acknowledges the contributions of other people in the relevant field. Next, I am coming to the question number 77. It is about time that criticism and philosophy acknowledged the disappearance or the death of the author. Which critic is credited with this statement? The right answer is Michel Foucault. The right answer is Michel Foucault. Next, coming to the question number 78. Given below are two statements, one marked assertion and the other reason. Let's read. Assertion: the essay is a literary form that is always subjective or personal. And the reason is, this is because it is possible to develop an argument within such a brief space. The right answer is option D, both A and R are correct. Next, question number 79. Who said, good prose is like a window pane? The right answer is option B, George Orwell. Next, coming to the question number 80. Who links literary genres to seasons? The right answer is option A, North of Fry. Next, question number 81. Which of these is not a contemporary theory of popular culture? The right answer is option B, string theory. Next, I am coming to the question number 82. With which theoretical movement can one associate the idea that a work of art should ideally be marked by distancing and estrangement rather than by cohesion and progression? The right answer is option B, the Frankfurt School. Next, I am coming to the question number 83. The film Apocalypse Now is an adaptation of. The right answer is Joseph Conrad's Heart of Darkness. Next, coming to the question 84. Horace in Ars Poetica states, poets have ever had equal authority for attempting anything, but not to such a degree. Choose the correct explanation of Horace's statement. The right answer is option D, Horace initiates a debate on decorum and poetic license. Next, coming to the question number 85. Which of the following 19th century literatures was the strongest proponent of the high culture or mass culture dichotomy that was finally erased by postmodernism? The right answer is option B, John Ruskin. Next, coming to the question number 86. According to which linguistic process did Latin pedem become English foot and Latin centum change to English hundred? The right answer is option A, Grimm's law. The right answer is option A, Grimm's law. Next, coming to the question number 87. The first canto of Virgil's Aeneid begins with a great storm that destroys the fleet of Aeneas, but later the storm comes down. Then this natural event has been presented in terms of the battle of gods. Who are the gods involved? द राइट आंसर इज ऑप्शन सी, जूनो, एओलास एंड नेपच्यून. द फर्स्ट पोएट टू हैव इवॉल्व्ड द सोनेट फॉर्म इज ऑप्शन ए, जियाकोमो द लेंटिनी. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन नंबर 89, व्हिच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इज नॉट करेक्ट. द राइट आंसर इज ऑप्शन बी, सिलेबल इज ए पार्ट ऑफ ए वर्ड व्हिच कैन नेवर हैव वन साइलेंट वोवेल लेटर. नेक्स्ट कमिंग टू द क्वेश्चन नंबर 90, इन हिज पोएटिक्स एरिस्टोटल सेज द ट्रेजेडीज ऑफ मोस्ट ऑफ द मॉडर्न आर कैरेक्टरलेस. व्हाट डज एरिस्टोटल मीन बाय कैरेक्टर. द राइट आंसर इज ऑप्शन बी, कैरेक्टर विथ ए मोरल पर्पस. नेक्स्ट आई एम कमिंग टू द क्वेश्चन नंबर 91. Then I noticed a small sketch in oils on a panel representing a woman wrapped and blindfolded carrying a lighted torch. The passage occurs in Heart of Darkness. The right answer is option C, Heart of Darkness. There is a matching list, list A with list B. I am directly going to the answer. The right answer is option A, that is B.C.D. Amboise is related to George Chapman. Antonio and Melida is related to Cyril Turner. Women Beware Women is related to Thomas Middleton. And The Revenger's Tragedy is related to John Marston. Next, coming to the question number 93, it is also a matching list. I am directly going to the option. The right answer is option B, that is Margaret Lawrence is related to the Diviners. Rohinton Mystery is related to Such a Long Journey. Margaret Atwood is related to Cat's Eye. Michael Ondaatje is related to Warlight. Next, coming to the question number 94. Which of the following are the characteristics of Butler English? The right answer is option B, that is B and C, deletion of verb inflections, and option C, deletion of prepositions. Next, I am coming to the question number 95. The 1979 film Juno is based on. The right answer is Ruskin Bond's A Flight of Pigeons. Next, question number 96. Which of these novelists was acknowledged by Salman Rushdie as his precursor in the use of chutneyfication of Indian English? The right answer is option C, G.V. Desani. Next, coming to the question number 97. In the first canto of Homer's Iliad, Agamemnon declined to free the daughter of Chirces, who afterwards invoked the god for revenge. Who is the god and does he fulfill Chirces' prayer? The right answer is option C, Apollo shot his arrows. Next, question number 98. Which of the only two states in India that still use English as their only official language? The right answer is Arunachal Pradesh and Nagaland. And the last two questions are 99 and 100. Question number 99. Which of the following characters has no mention in Milton's Paradise Lost Book 1? The right answer is option B, Gabriel. And the last question of this set is, who wrote a seminal treatise on Dalit aesthetics covering also the imagery and idioms appropriate for conveying the Dalit experience? The right answer is option D, Saran Kumar Limbel. Thank you all. Thank you for watching my videos. Please like, share and subscribe and click the all videos. And if there is any mistake, please comment in the comment box. Thank you all.